Good morning everyone, I'm Parvati from Christian College of Physiotherapy. So today I'm here to share some few things about syringomyelia. Syringomyelia is a rare neurogenic disease which can damage the spinal cord due to the formation of a fluid-filled area in the form of a cyst called syrinx, usually found in the high cervical spine. Causes: generally there are two forms of syringomyelia, congenital, acquired. Congenital: the first major form relates to an abnormality of the brain called Carey malformation. This is the most common cause of syringomyelia. Next one is acquired, the second major form of syringomyelia, which occurs as a complication of a trauma, meningitis, hemorrhage, a tumor or arachnoiditis. Etiology: it mostly occurs with a mean age of onset of 30 years. Rarely it may develop in childhood or late adulthood. Syringomyelia is most commonly found in men than in women. Clinical features of syringomyelia: gradual muscle atrophy, especially scapula and cervical neck muscles, muscle function loss and muscle weakness, persistent headaches, decreased reflexes in the arm, decreased sensation and sensitivity or even numbness, radiating pain through neck, shoulder, upper arm and upper trunk, incoordinated movement, spasm and involuntary muscle contraction, dizziness, jerky eye movement, sensory impairment on one or both sides of the face, muscle atrophy, claw hand, respiratory insufficiency, impaired bladder and bowel functions, neurogenic arthropathies, hyperhidrosis, edema and scoliosis. Diagnosis: MRI, electromyography, CT scans and myelogram. Differential diagnosis: hydromyelia, myelomalacia and cystic neoplasms. Management: medical management, medications like gabapentin or pregabalin are commonly given. Surgical management: syrinx can be relieved by surgical intervention. PT management: our aim is to improve range of motion, to improve muscle strength, to improve stability and to improve balance. For this, maintaining range of motion using stretching and mobilization of the neck and the upper limb, strengthening exercises, functional and balanced training programs, use of crutches and leg braces can be suggested. Thank you.